Hello all, in this tutorial we are going to learn about BDD testing framework Cucumber integration with Catalan Studio. Many of the agile teams have successfully implemented BDD, means behavior driven development method, to their testing process using Cucumber tool. What is Cucumber? Cucumber is a tool used to run automated acceptance tests created in BDD format. One of the most outstanding feature is the ability to carry out plain text functional description. It is written in language called as Gherkin. Automation tests in Cucumber are created in business domain language or in natural language, which can be understood by all team members. This is the example of the feature file wherein @tag means the tag to be given to the scenario, to group the scenario. Then these are the keywords which are mentioned in red. Feature, login to the application. Scenario, login with valid user credentials. Given, I navigate to Cura Health application homepage. When I click make appointment button and I enter username and password and I click login button, then I should be able to login successfully. This is the simple scenario of login to the application, and any person can understand by reading these steps that this is the login application scenario. So this is the example of the language, natural language, that can be understood by all the team members. And these are the test steps to be carried out to execute this scenario. Let's learn how to create the Cucumber test using BDD framework in Catalan Studio. To learn Cucumber testing using BDD framework in Catalan Studio, I'm going to use this Cura Healthcare Service application. In this application, we have to click on make appointment button and then we have to enter the username and password and then click on login button to log into the application. To create a Cucumber test using BDD framework in Catalan Studio, we have to first create the features file. To create a features file, we will click on include folder. In include folder, there is features folder. Right click to that folder, click new. You can create a new folder and then create a new feature file in that, or you can directly create a new feature file. I will create a feature file. Give the name to the feature file. This feature file will have the .feature extension. If you click this checkbox, it will generate with the sample feature template. If you uncheck this checkbox, it will open the blank feature file. Click OK. This is our feature file, which has the required details in it as it is a sample file. @tag is to group the scenarios. These are the keywords which we have seen in our example. These keywords we have to use in the feature file. So we will make changes in this one by one. And here we will mention that this is the login scenario. Then the feature will be login feature. Here they have given one message, text message. Instead of that, I will give my message that I want to log in. To the Cura Health application. Then there is one more tag, tag one, for the scenario. Here I will give that this is the valid credential check scenario. Scenario outline will be login with valid credentials. In given, we will write I navigate to Cura Health application. when I click on make appointment button. And I enter username and password, and I click login button. Then I should be able to log in successfully. Down here there are examples. Examples is nothing but the data that we are going to use in our test case. So in this test case we are obviously going to use the username and password. From here we will add the username and password. I will remove this. I will enter the username that we are going to use and the password. After entering the username and password over here, I will add them in the test case because we have not added in the features how these examples or these username and password data will be taken in the scenario. It will be taken with this syntax. But whatever I have written over here is highlighted. Why is it highlighted? If we check here, it shows that it is highlighted because it has not found the matching glue code for the example. For that, I have to add script for each of these steps. So how to add the script? Go to script folder. In the script folder, there is Groovy folder and the default package. You can create a script in the default package or you can create your own package and then create a script. I will create a new package by right clicking Groovy. And in the new, I can create a package. In this package, I will create a new script. You can create a Java or Groovy script. I will create a Groovy script by selecting step definition. And in this step definition, I will give the class name. Here also, you get the checkbox to check and generate the sample file, and you can generate the sample file or you can create your own file by unchecking this checkbox. I will check this checkbox and I will click OK. And my file will get generated like this, which will give me a sample file format. In this file format, I will add my steps, my details. So these are the annotations at the rate given, when, then, which we have used in the feature file over here. We have to copy this text. For example, from given, we have copied this text and we will go to at the rate given and we will paste this text over here. Then in definition, you can give any name. I will give the same name. I will just add the underscore in the spaces, and since I'm not passing anything over here, I will keep it blank. And inside this method definition, I will add my code. Now given what, I navigate to Cura Health application. To navigate to Cura Health application, I have to give the code over here. So I will give the code there. I will go to Cura Health login application test, which I have already created, and I will copy these two steps from there. And I will paste these two steps over here so that I will be able to navigate to the URL. What is next step? When I click on make appointment button, I will copy this and I will go to @when and I will paste this description over there. Then in the definition again, you can give any definition. I will give the same definition. Make sure that this text should match with the text in your feature file. Here also I'm not passing any parameters, so I will remove this and I will add the make appointment button click step over here. Then next is and, right? And I enter username and password. So before then I will write and. I will add and as the annotation and I will add this text in the double quotes. Here for this username and password parameters that we are passing, I will add dot star. If you check on W3 school website, it gives you the details of star and dot. Dot is any character except new line character and star means zero or more occurrences. I will add dot and star for username password and below that I will give the definition or the method name. For this method, we are going to pass the parameters as username and password. So I will add the parameters over here. And inside this method, we are going to write the steps to enter the username and password. I will keep this username as it is because we are going to pass this username as parameter. I have passed the password parameter for password and we have added these steps. Then we have given the next step as and I click login button. So again we have to add one more definition or one more method by giving @ and the text or our step inside the double quotes. Here we are not going to pass any parameter. I will create the method and in this method I am going to add the code to click login button. After this we have to give the details for then annotation. So we will go to our feature file and copy the text or the step which we have added for then. And here we have mentioned that then I should be able to log in successfully. So in the definition also I will mention the same and create a method. In then, I am going to check whether I have logged in successfully or not. Here, I am not going to pass any parameter and I am giving the code to verify whether I am able to log in. So, I will use the verify text keyword. And I will check that make appointment text is available or no. Then, I am going to log out. and I'm going to close the browser. We will save this, and this way we have created our test script and the feature file. If we check test feature file, even after creating the test scripts, the steps are showing highlighted. So for that, we have to right click over here and we have to recalculate the steps. Click recalculate. And now the warnings are gone. It has recalculated and it has aligned these steps with the script. Now let's execute it and check. Execute the feature file. The execution is done and it is passed. So this way you can work with the Cucumber test with the VDD framework in Catalan Studio. In the next tutorial, we will learn how to execute this Cucumber test from the test case and how to generate the Cucumber Runner class and how to execute or run the Cucumber test using that class. So stay tuned and keep learning. If you are new to this channel and would like to learn Catalan Studio from beginning to advanced, please click subscribe and bell icon below this video. Please do not forget to like and share. Thank you.